Alright. I don't want to say I told you so, but I told you so. But they tell you to say, you could bird it did link me in the garden and make me know, say, yo, before the end of this week, Coach Theodore Tapper Whitmore would be relieved of his duties as the national senior football coach. So said, so done. I tell you already, you know. My little birdie don't carry fake news. Well, it's not one bird. My flock of birds don't carry fake news. My source is impeccable. I told you clearly. All of you people who are on a YouTube land, who are on a YouTube channel, Oral Tracy Maverick, you are privy to the information first, you know. Consider yourselves amongst the privileged. Because the Maverick deal, you know. So despite all the uncertainty and the deliberation and the division about the decision, the JFF would be firing Tapper officially before the end of this week. Is which day of the week now? Today's Thursday. And which day me tell you that? Me tell you that about, is about Saturday or Sunday, me tell you that? Yeah, I think it's Sunday, me tell you that. Anyway, the JFF put out a thing officially now. Say, Coach Theodore Tapper Whitmore has been relieved of his duties and blah, blah, blah. They never went into all of the details that we expect them to go into, but they've not gone into that yet. But it's just that it has been now made official, yeah, that Tapper is no longer the Reggae Boys head coach. I remember when I spoke to you on the weekend, me just said to him, say, if we did hear who them were, I have to replace him out of the pool where we did mention. Because remember, they mentioned the pool there, no? Yeah. Well, what they put out, the information they gave out, they don't make it official or who they might appoint yet. But we can whisper and tell them that too. Well, people here already come and go talk it on the radio. But me understand, says Paul Hall, they might go for the assistant coach, Paul Hall. And I assume he will be hired on an interim basis to try and see out the World Cup qualifying campaign. And look at people. Tapper are a legend. Everybody knows the Tapper are a World Cup legend and Ray Ante. But it, as I've been saying, it's hard to defend a coach in a World Cup qualifying campaign. You have 14 games to play, and the first 8 you play, you have 6 points. Hard to defend Tapper this up. Even though we are in the midst of a 4-game unbeaten streak, and even though we all know that not all of the blame should be laid squarely at the feet of Tapper, some other issues that went into wear, into getting us in the unfortunate position we find ourselves. But make we sit up. But what we have to ask though, is it now that the JFF consider Paul Hall a better option to salvage the World Cup campaign from here? Yeah? That he will be able to take us to the World Cup while Tapper would not be able to, from where we are right now? Or is it that the JFF have given up on us qualifying for the World Cup from here? I mean, it's going to be difficult, you know. Mathematically, we're still in with a chance. But we're 7 points behind Panama in the 4th place playoff spot. I think the automatic spot them gone. See, I think them spot them gone. I think between the same, amongst Panama, Canada, USA, Mexico, the top automatic 3 are going to come from the group there. See, right now, as it is now, Canada, USA, Mexico kind of separate themselves. Well, not distinctly, but slightly. Slight separation that they are in. Panama now has also separated themselves from the chasing pack with Costa Rica in closer proximity to Jamaica, within touching distance of Jamaica. But the decision now must mean that this is where my curiosity then, you know. See, if them things say Paul Hall will be better able to qualify the team for the World Cup than Tapper Whitmore from here? Or is it that they give up on all the possibilities of qualifying for the World Cup? So Paul Hall is just there as an interim to see out the campaign, and then we build the program from this. Sad times, though, you know, brother. Sad times, and as I've been telling you already, is that Tapper alone to be blamed for where we are? See? We mismanage the process from the get-go. We mismanage the process. And I tell us how we sent an unsettled and a divided team into World Cup qualifying battle. Yeah. Divided and unsettled. Right now we 8 games in. See, fire the coach. See, I mean, I think we know our best team right now. I don't think we know our best team right now. See, that is not all down to Tapa. Some of it is his fault, you know. Because Mr. Tapa does some foolishness, you know. But Paul Hall now, Paul Hall coaching pedigree, we don't know. But I'm telling you what I'm going to in Jamaica, in the football program there right now too. You see the component of because of the British component in the squad. The narrative, you know, was around the fraternity was that Paul Hall will be better able to correspond and communicate to the England-based component of the squad than Tapa Whitmore. Yeah, Paul Hall will probably demand more respect from the England-born professionals than Tapa Whitmore would from the same. See, while Tapa, you don't know, Tapa have the respect and the commitment and the heart and soul of the original core of players when it start out. See, but we don't know. We have a maximum 24 more points can get from 6 games. You know, if you want to cling on to mathematics, we can say, yeah, we can win 5 out of them 6 there. But realistically, though, it don't look so pretty. It don't look so pretty. And we just hope the player them still come and give them all for the rest of the game, them. And if they can win the first one against Mexico, which will be at home, it'll give them a boost to go in and the rest of them forget a good push. I don't believe in quitting on them something, you know. Not even when you're mathematically out enough for quitting, you know. See? And is that no one find out in the coming days? If the headspace of the JFF leadership is at a quitting point, and this decision is a quitting decision, or them fully committed and them believe that we can still make it from here? That's a $1 million question. From a humanitarian standpoint, we feel it fit up about you can't serve your coach. We are getting them kind of results there. From a coaching perspective. From a humanitarian standpoint, a legend baller standpoint, a Jamaican standpoint, we never get the support, we never get the corporate support neither, you know. But you feel that Tapa never get the corporate support, you know. See? And a lot of this too, Tapa for blame for some other something, you know. Because Tapa communication skills is poor, you know. The funny thing with Tapa not talk about them, you know, him just then kind of crumoging around the whole thing and them talk about the whole thing. And more time we link Tapa and say, yo, come talk to it. Come on the radio, come tell the people what go on with the program and what go on with the football and what your plans are and what your strategy are and what your tactics are. And Tapa no one come. See? So when them crisis are reach him now, because how him carry himself and how him kind of, I don't know, some people say him should have talked, but I think, you know what, Tapa should come out and talk more about the football itself. In hindsight, if should come out and talk, meaning willing to engage Tapa anytime, you know, about the football itself, you know, about what going for the football field and what vision is for how him pick the team and the players him will pick and why him pick that kind of player there, and what formation him use and what he thinking behind the formation and how him study that up. And them something he didn't want to talk to Tapa about, you know. Sometimes he link Tapa and say, yo, make him come talk some football for the radio, Tapa. See? The man, so you know, the man, if I'm about and him don't want to talk, don't know if he's afraid to talk, because, but if you set up, it's not the politics with you and JFF me want to talk about, you know, and the football itself me want to talk about, Tapa still decline and know. One time him come for the program still, and we have to give him respect for that. See? But me don't know if like how the thing gone through, you know, we talk to me. But I just said, brother. They said, the peeps, yeah. And then the vehicle me there, you know, just go and bug-bang in the seat, you know. Come out for the road and just say, yo, me have to spill my mind. Because I been telling you, I told you so. So can I boast you when I say I told you so? No, but me not boasting, because I'm telling you, say, me been telling you so. So this is just a warning for when me telling you, say, my sources say, and the little bird fly down and say, see, I know what I'm saying, and I know what I'm doing. See? Anyway, people, spread the word, you know. And the Maverick, Oral Tracy Maverick, go on. Tell your friends about the channel. Yeah, you get it uncut around us, you know. As much as YouTube will allow me. If you push the boundaries too much, you don't know the more pressure me. But you get it uncut, you get some behind the scenes thing, you get some things where the people that be in the TV land and radio land don't hear. Exclusively, you get them faster too. You understand me? So just subscribe to the channel and tell your friend about the channel, Oral Tracy Maverick. And it's not just sports, I don't want no cylinder box, me know. It's not just sports, the topic I know is a sports topic. But we talk about a bag of things on the channel. Scroll up on the video and look on some of them. Yeah? Kedisha combo party and the last one I'm doing, you know. Check it out. Mad thing. Yeah? Anyway, people, I told you so.